our surroundings. A clean and ventilated house is necessary for our health, but clean surroundings are also important. The area we live in, the plants and animals that surround us are a part of the environment around our house. This environment must be kept clean. We should not litter it with garbage, sewage or other waste materials. A clean environment. A healthy body needs a clean environment. For a healthy body, two things are required: sanitation and hygiene. Hygiene means keeping yourself and your surroundings clean. Sanitation means creating a condition that prevents any disease. Dirty surroundings help in the growth of germs that cause diseases like cholera, typhoid, dengue and plague. Dirty and stagnant water is the breeding ground of mosquitoes. Mosquitoes cause malaria. Disposal of waste. Disposal of waste is also a very important part of a clean environment. All waste water from our kitchens, bathrooms, etc. should go through drains into underground pits. Most big cities have underground pipelines that are connected to the main sewage line. Solid waste like vegetable peels, waste paper, plastic bags, bottles and glass too should be thrown in covered garbage bins. Most people throw solid waste material out of their houses and not necessarily in the dustbin. This pile of solid waste attracts flies and germs, which in turn spread diseases. To prevent the spread of diseases, we must use covered dustbins or garbage dumps. Scientists have teaching people to dispose garbage in compost pit. The solid waste put in compost pits turn into manure after some time. All solid waste, however, do not change into manure. Things like fruits, vegetable peels and paper products, which change or decompose, are called biodegradable materials. They get absorbed in the soil. This soil is very fertile and is used by farmers in their fields. Few things like plastics and glasses do not decompose. These are called non-biodegradable materials. They remain unchanged in the soil for a very long time and pollute the soil. The three R's: reduce, reuse, recycle. Reduce. It means to use less. For example, we can save electricity by switching off unnecessary lights and fans. Reuse. It means to use a thing again. For example, the plastic or glass bottles in which we buy various food items like jam or pickle can be reused for storing different things in the kitchen. Recycle. We can recycle some of the waste materials and make beautiful things out of them. Recycling is reusing of materials like paper, glass, aluminium, plastic, etc. instead of discarding them. Recycled material is processed and treated in a certain way so that it can be used again. Advantages of recycling. We save our natural resources like trees, soil, water, etc. by recycling. When you recycle paper, you cut less trees to make more paper. We save energy as energy is used by factories to make new things. We save the environment by reducing the amount of waste produced by the factory.